Hi, we are at the auditorium of Marathwada Association of Small Scale Industries and Agriculture. It's called Srimati Ratnaprabha Balasaheb Pawar Sabhagruha. Let's go in. I am Amod from Consonance Acoustics, and in this video we will talk about how we have approached the designing of acoustics of this hall. So Masia wanted this to be a multi-purpose hall. Their main activity is hosting their general body meeting here. They also rent it out for musical performances or trainings and seminars. So we wanted to design this hall in such a way that music never sounds dead, it should sound full. At the same time, speech clarity cannot be compromised in this hall. So let me tell you how we've managed to do that. So when we first conducted the acoustical test of this hall, we found out that the reverberation time for frequencies below 500 Hz was above 4 seconds. Now that is too high. For a hall of this size, the ideal reverberation time should be between 0.6 to 0.9 seconds. As you can see, these chairs are cushioned and upholstered, so they are the biggest source for absorbing frequencies above 500 Hz. So much so that we did not really require a lot of absorption on the side walls. You can see that there are only these 5 absorbers on this side wall, and the rest of the area is kept blank. Let me show you how these absorbers work. So this is the broadband absorber. It is a 2-inch thick panel made of rock wool at the core, and there's fabric on both sides. Now we've also introduced a 100 mm air gap behind this. So what this air gap does is increase its efficiency slightly when absorbing a bit more of the lower frequencies. So this absorber is quite efficient at absorbing frequencies from 250 Hz to 20,000 Hz. So let me tell you why we have installed broadband absorbers on this back wall. We have these front of house speakers on the hall. They will emit sound in this direction. So what happens is, if this wall is bare, then there will be late reflections in the front areas or on the stage, and that will reduce sound clarity by a lot. These broadband absorbers help stop the reflection of that sound and hence increase the speech clarity. Now that we've managed the higher frequencies, let me show you how we've reduced the reverberation time for the lower frequencies. You can look at this ceiling. It's kind of this reversed stepped ceiling. All the steps that have the lights on them are actually our patented low frequency absorbers. And the steps that have these AC ducts are made of gypsum. You can see that the low frequency absorber is a very non-intrusive type of an absorber. It looks like the gypsum steps. It does a really good job at reducing the lower frequencies. Now let me show you the result. When we conducted the acoustical test after installing all these absorbers, this is what we found. You can look at this chart and see that the reverberation has reduced significantly for all the frequencies. It's between 0.6 and 0.9 from 125 to 8000 Hz. This was an ideal scenario for us. Now let me talk a bit about the stage. These are monitor speakers used for people on the stage to listen to themselves. They emit sound in this direction. What happens is the sound reflects back into the microphone from this back wall. This creates an infinity loop, and that results in a feedback sound. We want to avoid this at all costs. So usually there is always an absorbing layer on the stage. Now this is again a broadband absorber we've installed on the stage. You'll notice that we've not covered the entire stage. Now that is again to reduce the broadband absorption, otherwise the space will start sounding dead. So we've installed the exact amount that is required on the stage. So let me talk about the audio system. We at Consonance Acoustics not only design and install the acoustics, but also design and install audio systems for any space. I have a video that delves a bit deeper into how to choose speakers for any space. The link is in the description. You can check it out later. When we were in talks about what kind of an audio system to install in this space, there was a lot of chatter about installing a lot of speakers on the walls and FOH, etc. We've developed a software that tells us how many speakers we need, what kind of a sensitivity those speakers should have, and what is the power range that the speaker should have. Using that software, we found out that we only required two FOH speakers that had 96 decibels of sensitivity and a power between 300 to 400 hertz. We decided to go with Electro Voice EKX-12 speakers for this. And after installation and testing, we found out that the sound levels were balanced all across the auditorium. And we've also had really good reviews about how the auditorium sounds, both for music and for speech. So lastly, let me talk about the crown jewel, so to speak, of this auditorium, which is the Speech Transmission Index, or STI. When we tested this auditorium for STI, we found out that the STI for male talkers was 0.77 and STI for female talkers was 0.78. Now, according to IEC 60268-16, having an STI above 0.75 corresponds to the listener's understanding 96 to 100% of the sentences, which means this is a class A auditorium when it comes to speech intelligibility. This brings us to the end of the video. I hope you liked what you saw, and you share this with people who you think will find it interesting. If you want to watch more of such videos, please do not forget to subscribe and like this video. Bye-bye.